Good morning students, welcome in video lecture of electronic devices and circuits. We are discussing unit number 3, electronics amplifiers. In this unit we are discussing topic effect of feedback on terminal characteristics of amplifiers. In previous lecture we have discussed the same topic, and under that same topic, that means in effect of feedback on terminal characteristics of amplifiers, in that topic we have discussed the point as advantages and disadvantages of negative feedback. That means what exactly the negative feedback it is having the advantages, and as we know that in every thing that may be any related to, that means if you are considered the one of the law as the for you can say that anything may be there, in that if we are considering the advantages, then it should or it may having one or two disadvantages. We can take the example of that law as in every action there is equal and opposite reaction. Related to that, that law here it is not applicable one, but related to that, for anything, for any point, for any topic, any subject, if we are considering one, in that it is having the advantages as well as the disadvantages. So in that negative feedback, or in this negative feedback, it is having three to four main good advantages, and again I said that there may be or there is the disadvantages, so it is also having the some sort of the disadvantages, like the related to the gain, or you can see that its stability. Okay, so these are the some of the advantages it is having, and that thing we are discussed in previous lecture, right? So today under this topic effect of feedback on terminal characteristics of amplifier, we are going to discuss the input and output resistance with feedback. That means if we are considering the feedback, then what exactly that amplifier it is having the input resistance and output resistance, and how it is affecting on that particular relation, or you can see that parameters of the that particular amplifiers, by considering the current, by considering the voltage, by considering the current series, by considering the current shunt feedback, by considering the voltage series and voltage shunt, that thing we are going to discuss in today's lecture. So we will discuss the first point as the under this point as the input and output resistance with feedback as the input resistance. See, in the input resistance, that means any amplifier or any circuitry, whenever we are applying the any signal, okay, that signal it is given to the input terminals, that input terminal or that input section of the amplifier, it is having some sort of the resistance, and it is again depends on the how the amplifier it is configured over. That means the device which is used as the amplifier, how it is configured over, that means which kind of a common connection it is made, common drain, common source, common gate, or if you are considering the bipolar transistor, then common emitter, common base, common collector. Depending on that, the input resistance it is again giving the, that means variations, that may be large, that may be medium, that may be low, it depends on. Now if this same circuitry when it is considered with the feedback, then again how it is affecting one, that here we are going to discuss now. See here, in an input resistance, if the feedback signal is returned to the input in series with the applied voltage, then this input resistance increases. Okay, this input resistance again it is increases one. Now see here, again the next thing is that the feedback voltage Vf, if it is opposes the Vs, now feedback voltage is the Vf and Vs is the input voltage, then, or you can see that source voltage, then if it is opposes, then the input current I is the less than it would be if Vf were absent, right? So this is the some sort of the, you can see that consideration. Now hence the input resistance with the feedback, it is given as, see here, input resistance of the feedback, it is given as this RIF is equal to Vs upon II, which is greater than the input resistance without the feedback. It is the greater one. Why? Because there is the no feedback, right? That is RI is equal to RIF is equal to, if suppose you are considering the feedback, right, then RIF is equal to RI into 1 plus A beta, that is equal to RI dot D. That is the consideration. If with feedback RIF and without feedback RI. So these are the two different resistors. Now if suppose you are considering the with feedback, then this RIF, it is given by this. Now, negative feedback, in which the feedback signal is returned to the input in a shunt with the applied signal, right, then it is decreases the input, it decreases the input resistance. If it is connected with the shunt, then it is decreases, and if it is connected in a series, it is increases, right? So remember this one, and this happens when there is a, the feedback is obtained by sampling of the output current or voltage, regardless of the feedback, or whether the feedback, which kind of the sampling it is considered, regarding that, that means regardless that, you can consider this particular thing. Remember here only two things. If the feedback it is in the series, then you will get the high input resistance or increased input resistance. And if the feedback it is with shunt, then it is giving the output, input resistance as the less one, decreased one. Since Is is equal to II plus IF, then the current is drawn from the signal source is increased over what it would be if there were a no feedback. Now see here the, I said that, that means which kind of a connection you are doing one. It depends on that your, that particular resistance, it's you can say that you will get one. Now here voltage series feedback is there, then how the in series feedback it is connection it is done one, and how the RIF it is obtained one, it is considered, it is, you can say that shown in this particular figure. So Vs it is the input signal, Vf is the, here see here, this is the Vf, it is the feedback voltage, right? Now and related to that feedback voltage and Vs, you will get this particular RIF, right? Okay, in next point we are going to, in next slides we are going to see the output resistance. So remember this particular figure, because here ROF, that means whenever the feedback it is applied one, at that time how the output resistance it is considered one, it is shown in this. So and to obtain this particular RIF, okay, so here Thevenin's equivalent model it is considered for this particular amplifier, right? So this is the shown in this picture. So remember this, all the parameters VI, RI, Vs, here AV, VI, RL is the low resistance, and at the output side V out you are getting one, and by considering the RL, how the output resistance it is obtained one, and here without considering the RL, how the output resistance it is considered one, that it is shown. Now voltage series feedback voltage series feedback, it is again calculated as by considering the above figure. RIF is equal to RIF is equal to PS upon II, and PF is equal to B PO, that means beta PO. So here RI is again calculated as PI upon RI. Voltage series feedback circuit used to calculate the input and output resistance, and for this you are considering the KVL, that means here considering the KVL input loop, and which gives the different parameters, that means voltage Vs, which is considered by this particular values, V naught by considering these particular values, and from this you can calculate the that input and output resistance. Now here AV, that means gain of this voltage, it can be obtained by this particular equation. Now again from the that particular Vs equation from the previous slide, okay, you can calculate the Vs is equal to IRI plus beta VO, and Vs is equal to, by considering the all the parameters, it gives this particular result. Now finally you can get this particular RIF for this particular voltage series feedback. So it is calculated by using this particular equation. Here AV represents the open circuit, that particular gain without feedback, and this AV small a, that means AV with small v and A with small some large v, it indicates different that particular thing. So without feedback and with feedback, it is giving that particular result. Okay, it can be calculated. Now here this AV, it gives the load which is considered in the account. Okay, now by considering that thing, we are calculated. By using the same circuit, here current series feedback can be obtained as current series. See, we are discussing the series feedback. So RIF is equal to RI into I plus beta GM, where GM is the I naught upon VI, and this relation gives this particular, you can see that RIF. So this GM, with considering the that particular parameters, all the parameters, input that means current and voltage parameters, it is considered, by considering that it is calculated. Now by considering the previous figure, only the here current shunt feedback consideration it is done one. Now in this current shunt, see whatever the input source you are considering, one here you are considering the current as the input source, and by considering the input source, again you are using the Norton's model for the calculation of this particular, you can see that parameters of the resistance. So remember this particular circuit once again, because you are considering the with feedback, and in that RIF is equal to VI upon IS, it is the given the this gives the this particular input resistance. And same thing I already discussed in previous slide, as whatever the this output part is there, it is with consideration of the load resistance, and without considering the load resistance, that can be calculated the output resistance. Okay, now see these equations gives, because here this is the current shunt feedback, okay, and for the, which is giving the calculation of the input and output resistance. So here IS is equal to II plus IF, that means this is the your feedback current, right? So that is again IF, it is considered in the consideration of this beta parameter. So total this I naught is equal to like this. So from this here AI, that means again current gain, it is considered one. So from this you can calculate the this particular RIF. See here stepwise IS is equal to, that means II plus B beta I naught, right? By using this relation you can get, that means input voltage and this particular resistance variation, because you are considering the current, you can say that relation. So by using this all the things, you are getting the this RIF as the input resistance. Okay, so as description, AI represents the short circuit current gain and AI indicates the current gain without feedback taking with the load into account. So this is the result. Now voltage as the shunt feedback. See, whenever you are considering the shunt feedback, then RIF is equal to RI upon 1 plus beta RM. So here RM is equal to again V naught upon I. So by using this relation, you can calculate the particular RI. Okay. So, and for that you can use this same, because it is open circuit trans resistance, where RM is the trans resistance without feedback taking into load. So by considering this, you can calculate the RI here. Now same can be considered for the output resistance. Whatever the shunt and series connection is there, that can be considered for the output resistance. Now see here, what here output resistance consideration is there. Negative feedback which samples the output voltage tends to decrease the output resistance. That means RI, if RI increases, V naught also increases. Hence the output voltage tends to remain constant as RI changes. This argument leads to the conclusion that this type of a feedback sampling the output voltage reduces the output resistance. See, RI, it is remains constant, but here output voltage tends to remain constant as there is a change in the RI, right? There is a change in the that particular RI and the output resistance tends to remain constant. Okay, so these arguments again say that leads to the conclusion that this type of feedback reduces the output resistance. Now again, by considering the series and shunt feedback, how it is calculated, one see here. To find out, by considering the voltage series feedback, R naught F, that means we have to find out the R naught F. So we have to consider some sort of the, that means whatever the external source is there, we have to remove one. That means we have to maintain it as the Vs is equal to 0. That means current, obviously Vs is 0, that means Is is 0. And let RI, it is high one, because it's in, as input resistance it is increases one, right? So which impress a voltage V across the output terminals and calculate the current I delivered by the VN. Then R naught F, it is equal to VI upon I dash. Thus from the figure, previous figure, with V naught replaced by V, I is equal to V minus AV VI divided by R naught, which is leads to V plus beta AV into V into R. So this equation gives that particular. Now, because this particular Vs is equal to 0, Vi is equal to minus F, right? And that's why Vi is equal to, Vs is equal to 0, Vi is equal to minus F, that is equal to minus B beta V. So R naught F is equal to V upon I, which gives the relation in terms of the resistance as R naught upon 1 plus beta. And for that particular considering the load, R naught F dash is equal to R naught F parallel to RL into R naught F, which is the R naught upon 1 plus beta, because it is a parallel. So R naught for the shunt feedback voltage, shunt feedback, R naught F is equal to again given as R naught upon 1 plus beta RL, right? And that R naught dash is equal to R naught dash upon 1 plus beta RM, right? So current shunt feedback again from figure B, right? Current circuitry we are having the different, that means series and current. So for that beta, V naught, it is replaced by V, that means I is equal to V upon R naught minus AI into I. So with IS is equal to 0, I is equal to minus beta I naught, that is equal to plus beta I. Hence I is equal to V upon R naught minus beta I AI into I, that is leads to 1 I into 1 plus beta AI, that is equal to V upon R naught. So from that we can get the R naught F is equal to V upon I, that is equal to R naught 1 plus beta. So this is the one equation for the current shunt. If we are considering the load resistance, this equation can be obtained. Here, for RL is equal to higher 1, AI is equal to 0, and R0 dash is equal to order. That means that load resistance, if it is high 1, then at that condition, both with load and without load, this is the equal. So, therefore, R dash not F is equal to R0 1 plus AI. Now, for current series feedback, R0F is equal to R0 1 plus beta GM into, and okay, this is the one case, R0F is equal to R0 1 plus beta GM, and second one is the R dash not F is equal to R0 dash 1 plus beta GM upon 1 plus beta. So this equation leads to, so this is the some sort of that particular relation of the current shunt and current series, how that particular equations can be calculated. So here today we discussed the two things related to this particular you can say that characteristics of the amplifier, okay, terminal, that effect of that particular feedback on the characteristics of the amplifier, that we have discussed one with the help of this particular input resistance and output resistance, and in that the shunt and series connection for that particular voltage as well as the current, how it is affecting on that particular resistance, that we have discussed. Students, if you are having any query related to this particular today's video lecture and topic, you can ask me anytime. I will clarify all the things, and you can get this particular thing from this particular PDF also. You can check it once, repeat that particular video for the understanding one. And even though if you are having any query, you can ask me anytime. This is the one thing. Another thing is that I am sharing the MCQ for every video lecture. You just go through that particular MCQs and solve that particular MCQ related to this particular topics. Thank you. Be safe and study well.